Good morning, Mark Twain. This is the morning news broadcast live from the library studio with your hosts, the TBD News Squad. Now to the anchors.
TV. I'm Nicholas.
And I'm Sophie. Today is Tuesday, April 16th, 2013. It's now time for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Will you all please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Attention, eighth graders. The deadline for court tour essays is coming soon. If you would like to go on the court tour, you must get your essay turned in by this Friday, April 19th. See your civics teacher for more information. Remember that the court tour is an awesome trip, so don't delay.
So, the fourth quarter just started. Literally, it started today. But it doesn't mean you can slouch on your service learning. Maybe you want to get started on it now. There will be a volunteer fair on Thursday, April 18th from 6 to 9 p.m. at Irving Middle School, just down the road from Twain.
Representatives from many organizations that offer service opportunities, such as Greenbrier Learning Center, Green Spring Village, Habitat for Humanity, Volunteer Fairfax, and others, will be in there to talk to students about how to get involved.
You know, 7th graders, your time to do service learning is approaching soon. You could go and see what might be interesting to do next year. Remember that hours done over the summer can count for first quarter service learning.
A big congratulations to the Twain Theater Sports Team of Kirabel Akiliu, Zachary Alexander, Aaron Jaff, Sophia Nade, William Pineda, and John Warnock. They placed second at the theater sports competition at Robinson Secondary School this past Friday night. Good job, all.
You know, spring allergy season is coming. This means we need your tissues. Remember how you were supposed to give two boxes to your social studies teacher at the beginning of the year? Well, if they're still in your locker, you should check. Better yet, feel free to donate a box or two to help the cause. Get your tissue boxes to your social studies teachers. You ever blow your nose on copy paper? It ain't a pretty sight. Let's fix this before it gets out of our nose or hands.
Remember, 7th graders, today author Priscilla Cummings will be here during 7th period to speak with you about what it's like to write a book. All staff are welcome to check it out, too. Well, that's all we have for you today from the studio. I'm Nicholas.
And I'm Sophie. Stay tuned for the Administration's Corner in the Minute of Silence after these messages.
Don't forget to follow us on Twitter and Instagram at TwainTV. And check out youtube.com/TwainMSNews to watch the News Crew productions.
Have a great day, Twain.
Twain, it is time for your daily joke. What do you call a fake noodle? An impasta. Have a great day, Twain.
Which is more important, words or numbers? Milo is a bored young man looking for adventure when he receives a mysterious gift that leads him to the lands of Dictionopolis and Digitopolis, where King Azaz and the Mathemagician have banished Princess's sweet rhyme and pure reason, causing chaos to ensue. With the help of Talk and Humbug, Milo must battle the demons to rescue the princesses. Will he succeed? Come see The Phantom Tollbooth, Friday, April 19th at 7:30, Saturday, April 20th at 2 o'clock and 7:30, and Sunday, April 21st at 2 o'clock to find out. Tickets are just $5 and will be sold at lunch and at the door. Join us after any 2 o'clock performance to meet Milo and the rest of the inhabitants of Dictionopolis and Digitopolis.
Good morning, Twain. I hope everyone is having a terrific Tuesday thus far. First report is all buses are in and on time. All buses are in and on time. Next, just want to say, if you still have these course preference sheets, let me see. Okay, there you go. If you still have these course preference sheets and you're a rising eighth grader, that means our current seventh graders, please be sure to drop them off in student services. And then for those of you who are going to high school, you've also received your course registration sheet, so please be sure to drop those off in student services as well. Next announcement, report cards will be distributed next Tuesday. Again, report cards will be distributed next Tuesday during seventh period. And our zero tardy party will be next Friday. It's moving to Friday, April 26th. Finally, today is the start of the fourth quarter. That means you guys are all starting off with A's. Your only job is to maintain that through the rest of the quarter. I hope, again, you have a wonderful, terrific Tuesday and enjoy the first day of the last quarter for the school year.